Good afternoon. Yesterday we studied about the conversion of higher order differential equation to first order differential equation as a system in a system of first order differential equation and vice versa. And today we have to learn about the solution of a system of first order differential equation and some theorems, 2-3 theorems connecting to the solution of system of first order differential equation. Theorems that are existence and uniqueness of solution and principle of superpositions are to be studied today. We have to define first the solution of a system of first order differential equation. For that we have n first order differential equation and as a system, the system of first order equations in n dependent variables is given. X1 dash is equal to f1 of t, x1, x2, etc. xn. X2 dash is equal to f2 of t, x1, x2, etc. xn, etc. xn dash is equal to fn of t, x1, x2, etc. xn. Is said to have a solution on the interval I from alpha less than t less than beta if there exists a set of n functions such x1 equal to 5, all the variables x1 equal to 5 1t, x2 is equal to 5 2t, etc. xn equal to 5nt that are differentiable at all points in the interval I and that they satisfy the equation 1 at all points in this interval. So we have to exist, there exist solutions for all variables x1, x2 and that satisfies the equation 1 in the interval or in the interval I at all points. Next we have the existence and uniqueness theorem for a system of for solution of system of differential equations. First, the nonlinear case. Consider let each of the function f1, f2, etc. fn and the partial derivatives dou f1 by dou x1, dou f2 by dou x2 and dou fn by dou xn be continuous in a region R of x1, x2, etc. xn space defined by alpha less than t less than beta, alpha 1 less than x1 less than beta 1, etc. alpha n less than xn less than beta n. And let the point t0, x1 0, x2 0 and etc. xn0 be in R. Then there is an interval mod t minus t0 less than h in which there exists a unique solution x1 equal to 5 1t, x2 equal to 5 2t and etc. xn equal to 5nt of the system of differential equations we have defined in 1 and that also satisfies the initial conditions x1 t0 is equal to x1 0, x2 t0 is equal to x2 0, etc. xn t0 is equal to xn0. The functions f1 to xn and partial derivatives are continuous in this space, in this interval or in each oro x1 space ilum oro interval and alpha 1 less than x1 less than beta, etc. alpha n less than xn less than beta. Pinne time inum oru interval undu alpha less than t less than beta. Anganeyanengil we have a solution x1 equal to 5 1t, x2 equal to 5 2t such that it satisfies the initial condition. Now we have theorem for linear cases. So consider the following system of n linear equation x1 dash equal to p11 t of x1, p12 t of x2, p1 etc, p1n t of xn plus g1t. x2 dash equal to p21 t of x1, p22 t of x2 etc, p2n t of xn plus g2t etc. xn dash is equal to pn1 t of x1, pn2 t of x2 plus etc, pnn t of xn plus gnt. If the function p11, p12, etc, pnn, g1, g2, etc, gn are continuous on an open interval I, alpha less than t less than beta, then there exists a unique solution x1 equal to 5 1t, x2 equal to 5 2t, etc, xn equal to 5nt of the system 4. This is 4. that also satisfies this the condition x1 t0. We earlier we defined the same initial condition x1 t0 equal to x1 naught, x2 t0 equal to x2 naught, etc. xn t0 equal to xn naught, where t0 is a specified value of t and x1 naught, x2 naught, xn naught are prescribed numbers. Moreover, the solution exists throughout the interval I. Now we have the principle of superposition. If we know two solutions x1t and x2t, then they are linear combination. C1 x1 plus C2 x2 is also a solution. The vector functions, that's the principle of superposition. The vector functions x1 and x2, which is a system that we call an, are solutions of the homogeneous system of linear equation x dash equal to p of t into x. Then the linear combination x1 x1 plus c2 x2 is also a solution for any constant c1 and c2. Given that x1 and x2 are solutions of x dash is equal to p of t into x. So we can take this as an equation A. Since x1 is a solution, it satisfies A. So that is d by dt of x1 is equal to p of t into x1. Equation 1. Since x2 is a solution, it satisfies A. That is d by dt of x2 is equal to p of t into x2. This is equation 2. Consider d by dt of, we have to show that c1 x1 plus c2 x2 is a solution of equation A. For that, consider d by dt of c1 x1 plus c2 x2, which is equal to d by dt of, we can take out the constant c1 x1 plus c2 into d by dt of x2. Using equation 1, this becomes c1 into p of t into x1 plus c2 into p of t x2. This p of t we can take, the common term p of t we can take outside. So this becomes c1 x1 plus c2 x2. That is c1 x1 plus c2 x2 satisfies equation A. That is c1 x1 plus c2 x2 is a solution of, is also a solution of x dash is equal to p of t into x. Next problem is, show that x1t is equal to e raised to 3t, 2 e raised to 3t, and x2t is equal to e raised to minus t, minus 2 e raised to minus t are solutions of x dash equal to 1141x. Also verify the principle of superposition. So first part, we have to verify this is the solution. So we have to, first we have to show that x1t is a solution. For that, find d by dt of x1t is equal to d by dt of e raised to 3t, 2 e raised to 3t, which is equal to e raised to 3t, the derivative is 3 into e raised to 3t. This is 2 into 3, 6 into e raised to 3t. So now 1141, now the right part 1141 into x1t is equal to 1141 into e raised to 3t into 2 e raised to 3t, which is equal to matrix multiplication e raised to 3t plus 2 e raised to 3t, 4 e raised to 3t plus 2 e raised to 3t, which is equal to 3 e raised to 3t plus 6 e raised, next term is 6 e raised to 3t. So this term is same as this term, that is d by dt of x1t is equal to 1141 into x1t. Now consider, that is x1t is a solution. Consider d by dt of x2t, which is equal to d by dt of x2t is e raised to minus t minus 2 e raised to minus t. Which is equal to derivative is e raised to minus t to derivative minus e raised to minus t minus 2 into minus 1 plus 2 e raised to minus t. So now consider 1141 into e raised to minus t minus 2 e raised to minus t, which is equal to 1 into e raised to minus t is e raised to minus t minus 2 e raised to minus t, 4 e raised to minus t minus 2 e raised to minus t, which is equal to e raised to minus t minus 2, 1 minus 2 which is minus 1 minus e raised to minus t, 4 minus 2 is 2 e raised to minus t, that is this expression is same as this one, that is d by dt of x2 of t is equal to 1141 x2 of t, that is x2 of t is a solution. For any two constants C1 and C2, consider we have to show that C1 x1 plus C2 x2 is a solution of given equation. So C1 x1 plus C2 x2, which is equal to d by dt of c1 into x1 is e raised to 3t 2 e raised to 3t plus c2 into e raised to minus t minus 2 e raised to minus t, which is equal to d by dt of c1 e raised to 3t plus c2 e raised to minus t 2c1 e raised to 3t minus 2c2 e raised to minus t. If we take the derivative, c1 e raised to 3t derivative is 3c1 e raised to 3t minus c2 e raised to minus t 2c1 e raised to 3t, derivative is 6e1 e raised to 3t minus 2c2 plus 2c2 e raised to minus t. So now consider 1141 into p of t into c1 x1 plus c2 x2 which is equal to 1141 c1 into e raised to 3t to e raised to 3t plus c2 e raised to minus t minus 2 e raised to minus t which is equal to 1141 into c1 e raised to 3t plus c2 e raised to minus t 2c1 e raised to 3t minus 2c2 e raised to minus t c1 e raised to 3t plus c2 e raised to minus t for c1 e raised to 3t plus 4c2 e raised to minus t plus 2c1 e raised to 3t minus 2c2 e raised to minus t which is equal to 3c1 e raised to 3t minus c2 e raised to minus t 6c1 e raised to 3t plus 2c2 e raised to minus t. That is d by dt of c1 x1 plus c2 x2 is equal to 1141 into c1 x1 plus c2 x2. Therefore, x1 and x2 satisfy principle of superposition. Principle of superposition.